What's up, math fans? The theme of this video is substitution. Find and replace. Find and replace. So this is just some basic stuff. Operations with functions. All right. Hopefully you're comfortable with replacement or find and replace or substitution. So here's a function, f of x equals x plus 2. And if you have any experience with this, f of x is just another way of saying y. A function is a relationship between x and y, or two different variables. So f of x is x plus 2. I just gave you an example of a function here. Here's a little more complicated function, g of x. And I even gave you a third one, h of x is x times f of x. So these are three functions that we're going to deal with. And what are operations? The basic four operations are add, subtract, multiply, and divide. So we're going to do some practice of operations with functions. First, let's get comfortable with what a function is. So for part A, I just want to evaluate g of negative 7. Well, g of x, meaning g of any number, is this formula here. So all I'm going to do is replace it. Where I see an x, I'm going to replace it with negative 7. Find and replace. Up, found it, replace it. So that's negative 7 squared plus 5 times negative 7 minus 14. Simple as that. That is 49 minus 35 minus 14. 49 minus 35 happens to be 14, and then 14 minus 14, 0. So g of negative 7 is 0. And what that means is negative 7 happens to be a 0, or a root of this. And that was a coincidence. Really, you can plug in any number and get any answer. I happen to have picked the root just for fun. All right, so what that says is x plus 7 is a root, or is a factor of this. And we talked about factoring in another video. I just kind of wanted to tie that in. All right, so basically for this one, you just find and replace. I replaced the negative 7 and I did math. I did PEMDAS, order of operations. How about f of negative x? So that's saying go to f of x, and wherever you see an x, just replace it with negative x. A lot of people freak out. Oh no, a letter, I thought it was only up. It's okay, you can put letters, you can put numbers, you can put smiley face if you want. You can do f of smiley face, but I'm gonna do f of negative x. So that's, let's see, I'm gonna replace this x with a negative x. So that's negative x plus 2. Let me just combine, no, solve, no, that's it, I'm done. All right, simple as that. You just find and replace. And I did wanna point out that you'll notice if f of negative x works out to be the same as f of x, you have an even function. But it did not work out to be the same, so it's not an even function. It might be odd, but actually it works out to be neither. You'll see my video on even and odd functions to understand what I mean by that. But here, again, find and replace. Let's go to c. Here I want you to take the whole entire f of x and add it to g of x. So I'm gonna find and replace wherever I say, well, what's f of x? X plus 2, so that is x plus 2, plus, I'm gonna add that to g of x, which is x squared plus 5x minus 14. Some people might put parentheses like this, f of x plus g of x, but I know when I'm adding, I don't really need the parentheses. I'm just gonna combine my like terms. So I see a 2, I'm gonna combine that with the negative 14, and then I see a x, I'm gonna combine that with a 5x. X squared has nobody to combine with, so my answer is gonna be x squared plus 6x minus positive 2 minus 14 is minus or negative 12. And there is my sum, all right? So that's an operation with two functions. I added them, combined like terms, I'm done. Subtract, same setup. Here I got x plus 2 minus x squared plus 5x minus 14. Some of you learned a bunch of different ways you can kind of bring this and put it underneath, or you can keep change, or you can distribute the negative sign. There's a bunch of different ways to subtract. So if I distribute the negative sign, it really is x plus 2 minus x squared minus 5x, and then plus 14. What happens is I change all three signs here in the subtrahend. So again, I combine like terms. This time I have negative x squared. X and negative 5x is negative 4x. Positive 2 and positive 14 is positive 16. And hopefully you're pausing, rewinding, checking my work on the way. All right, so there is the difference. That's the second operation with functions. Ooh, division, finally, some real hard stuff. What's g of x? G of x is that, all right, x squared plus 5x minus 14 divide by f of x, which is x plus 2. So there's got to be a stipulation here that x cannot equal negative 2. Stipulation, x does not equal negative 2. Because if it was negative 2 and I plugged it in, negative 2 plus 2 is 0, and you can't divide by 0. So I'll always add a stipulation like that. But that doesn't change my division. I still have to divide. So this divided by this. If you learned polynomial division, you can do long division here. And I do have a video. Find it. Or, actually, I could just factor this. So this becomes x, what is that? I'm going to do, people call that reverse FOIL. I call it sum product method. So this is x plus 7 times x minus 2 over x plus 2. And I wish that these would cancel, but they don't. So I actually am going to leave it like that. This is no simpler I can get it. So I'm going to leave it just like that. Had I had it reversed and this was a plus 2 here, then I would have canceled and my quotient would have been just x plus 7, which would have been cool. But it's okay to leave it like that. All right. And finally, f of x times h, what is this, h of x? H of x is x times f of x. So I got to really do f of x, oh, I don't have to write that again. I'm going to do, want some space? Let's get some space. Let's see, what's f of x? X plus 2 times x times, what's h of x? This is a lot here. So my f of x is there, x plus 2. My h of x is really x times f of x. So that's x times x plus 2. All right? So then I just got to distribute here. I get x squared plus 2x. And then I'm going to do a little bit of FOIL. And hopefully you can do that one on your own. I got x cubed plus 2x squared plus another 2x squared plus 4x. And if I combine my like terms, I have x cubed plus 4x squared plus 4x. And depending on if it's multiple choice or whatever, you could go further, you could factor it, but I multiplied, I'm done. That's my fourth operation. So now you know how to add, subtract, multiply, divide, basically find and replace, okay? Feel free to comment if you have any questions or comments or corrections. Thanks for watching. See ya.